I love it. It's
ancient tongue, you are Dovahkiin, Dragonborn.
Looking to hire. Where are you headed? The one with the ruined castle? I'll take you as far as I can, but I'm not hanging.
Climb on in and let's get this over with.
Right behind you.
I like to explore. My parents almost never let me off the island, so yeah, I poked around down here a lot. It was a little quieter back then. Guess a little vampire girl was enough to scare off the rats. I was, but I think I turned out okay. I was just thinking about a book I read once. It was by a scholar named Aryo Avelin. He supposedly found a way to create a sentient encyclopedia, if books could even think for themselves. Isn't our soul what makes us sentient? Not like dull automatons or zombies. Or perhaps it's something else, or a combination of things. Just some food for thought.
So far, this hasn't been too bad.
Before my father became obsessed with the prophecy, Mother and I spent quite a bit of time together. She was very fond of her alchemical garden in the castle courtyard. She taught me quite a bit about cultivating quality regions. Like the best of friends, I would never hesitate to share anything with her. It was very sudden. It was almost like one day we were a normal family, and then the next, I didn't know who they were. I'd try to visit my mother in the garden, and she'd quickly shoo me away, saying she was much too busy.
I'm ready if you are.
Who's there?
Good night. The old water system. On some days, would just be glad to hear that.
Stay on your guard.
Close quarters it is then. That'll teach you.
Got you!
So far, I think. Thanks. Yeah, actually. No one's ever been so genuine with me. At least, in a while. I was lonely most of my childhood. My mother, at least for a time, was the only friend I ever had. And then that prophecy came along. Had to get that out of my chest. This is getting a little awkward. I think I have a sudden urge to feed on something. You can be a real horker sometimes. You know that? I'm not actually hungry, at least for the moment. All right, I have to say it now. Here goes. I've come to really care about you. I just wanted you to know that. I'm glad to hear that. Let's get going then.
done and done. This leads out to the courtyard. Just head for the door.
We've made it to the courtyard.
Oh no. What happened to this place? Everything's been torn down. The whole place looks, well, dead. It's like we're the first to set foot here in centuries. This used to lead to the castle's great hall. It looks like my father had it sealed up. I used to walk through here after evening meals. It was beautiful once. This was my mother's garden. Do you know how beautiful something can be when it's tended by a master for hundreds of years? She would have hated to see it like this. Wait. Something's wrong with the moon dial here. Some of the crests are missing, and the dial is askew. I didn't even know the crests could be removed. Maybe my mother's trying to tell us something? I'm telling you, there's something strange with the moon dial. If I had to guess, I'd say the moment Mother fled the castle, Father went on a rampage.
Very clever, Mother. Very clever. I've never been in those tunnels before, but I'd bet they run right under the courtyard and into the tower ruins. Well, at least we're getting closer. Let's go.
Doesn't this courtyard look nice? It's serene in a certain way, and uniquely beautiful, like a certain... maybe. No, I wasn't talking about you. Well, I was. Well, it's entirely possible. Now, enough of that. We got a job to do. It's on.
My fellow, it's serene in a certain way, and uniquely beautiful, like a certain...
I'm ready if you are. Wait. There you are.
Want to be trifled with. Well done, Serana. Nice. Really are as elegant as an ice wraith. I don't think we've reached the top yet. I bet there's some sort of secret passage around here. Leave it to my mother, always smarter than I gave her credit. Look at this place. This has to be it. I knew she was deep into necromancy. I mean, she taught me everything I know. But I had no idea she had a setup like this. Look at all of this. She must have spent years collecting these components. And what's this thing? I'm not sure about the... circle, but it's obviously something.
Let's take a look around. There has to be something here that tells us where she's gone. My mother was meticulous about her research. If we find her research notes, there might be some hints in there. There's not a whole lot to tell. Keep searching for her notes. I had no idea that her laboratory even existed. She had an alchemy set up in her drawing room, but nothing that even comes close to what's here. Looking at the equipment and materials, it looks like she was trying to advance her necromancy. I don't know. Certainly not longevity. Kind of a waste of time for a vampire. I remember she used to keep a small journal. See if you can dig that up. Any luck yet? You did? Let me see. I only know what she told me. She had a theory about soul gems. That the soul cairn is home to very powerful beings. Necromancers send them souls and receive powers of their own in return. My mother spent a lot of time trying to contact them directly, to travel to the soul cairn. That circle in the center of the room is definitely some type of portal. If I'm reading this right, there's a formula here that should give a safe passage into the soul cairn. A handful of soul gem shards, some finely ground bone meal, a good bit of purified void salts. Oh, damn it. We're also going to need a sample of her blood, which, if we could get that, we wouldn't even be trying to do this in the first place. Not bad. We'd better hope that it's good enough. Mistakes with these kinds of portals can be gruesome. Anyway, enough of that. Let's get started. Oh, definitely. Mother would have plenty of those materials in her laboratory. You just need to find them. Created a portal to the soul. Incredible. Incredible. Simply incredible. I'm ready when you are. Are you alright? That looked painful. Now that I think about it, I should have expected that. Sorry. It's hard to describe. The soul cairn is, well, hungry, for a lack of a better word. It's trying to take your life essence as payment. There might be, but I don't think you're going to like it. Vampires aren't counted among the living. I could probably go through there without a problem. Not your first choice, I guess. Maybe. We could just pay the toll another way. It wants a soul, so we give it a soul. Yours. My mother taught me a trick or two. I could partially soul trap you and offer that gem to the ideal masters. That might be enough to satisfy them. It would make you a bit weaker when we travel through the Soul Cairn, but we might be able to fix that once we're inside. Maybe. I'm sorry. I wish I knew a better way. Something that would be easier for you. Just know that, whatever path you choose, I won't think any less of you. Sometimes, things just have to be done. I know that better than anybody. Do you need something? Are you sure? I'm willing to turn you, but you need to think it through. You'd become the very thing you've sworn to destroy. I don't know how the Dongar will react. Turning someone is a very personal thing for vampires. It's intimate for us. I don't want you to feel like I'm forcing you into this. Let's not waste too much time then. I promise to try and make this as painless as possible. Hold still. The smell here. Let's try to handle this quickly. But looks like we'll be dealing with the smell of rot while we're here. Lovely. If she really is here, I wonder... How do you manage to deal with it then? Me? I smell like nightshade and snowberries. Oh, you know what? You should be talking. I have a heightened sense of smell, you know. If you think you smell like blossoms after frolicking in a fetid cave, you are sorely mistaken. But, hey, you're actually not too bad. For a well-groomed bear. Porker face. Well, that is just not true anymore. We're being awfully carefree, aren't we? I mean, for being trapped in a realm of oblivion with no guaranteed return. It's nice. It's just have fun. Have someone who can help me forget about old prophecies, Elder Scrolls, trails, and this awful God's curse of weak. About all of this, even for a brief moment. I'm starting to like you, okay? You're growing on me. And what I said is true, though I definitely wouldn't want to end up here for all eternity. You got a job to do. Let's find my mother and find a way out of here.
I can't remember how long I've been here. Has it been a day or a century?
Where am I?
I've got you in my sights. I'm not someone to be trifled with.
Deserve to be in a place like this. Arvak. my horse. We came to this horrible place. Please, he's such a loyal creature, and he's been running for so long. You have to save him. A place like this will change you. Arvak! Arvak! Where are you? Arvak, please come back! Come back!
Mm-hmm.
What these souls do all day. They look...
I've always wondered what the Dwemer actually looked like. If one believes Nord... But what... Maybe there were other differences. Lighter skin tone. Or... tails? No. Why would they have tails? I don't know.
Someone with flesh on their bones. Let's just say I sold something to a guy who turned out to work for a whole coven of necromancers. How in the name of Zenith was I to know the ingredients were phony? Do I look like someone that would double-cross a necromancer? You got it. Horse, wagon, and all. Plopped here without so much as a word. I used to be one of the best traders in High Rock, you know. How people would track me down just to see what I had for sale. Very funny. And what exactly are you going to pay me with? Take a look around. Gold doesn't exactly win you any friends around here.
Thank you.
Serana? Is it really you? I can't believe it. How do we get inside? We have to talk.
Serana, what are you doing here? Where's your father?
He doesn't know we're here. I don't have time to explain.
I must have failed. Harkon's found a way to decipher the prophecy, hasn't he?
No, you've got it all wrong. We're here to stop him, to make everything right.
Wait a moment. You've brought a stranger here. Have you lost your mind?
No, you don't...
You, come forward. I would speak with you.
So how has it come to pass that a vampire hunter is in the company of my daughter? It pains me to think you'd travel with Serana under the guise of her protector in an effort to hunt me down. Coming from one who murders vampires as a trade, I find it hard to believe your intentions are noble. Serana has sacrificed everything to prevent Harkon from completing the prophecy. I would have expected her to explain that to you. You think I'd have the audacity to place my own daughter in that tomb for the protection of her Elder Scroll alone? The scrolls are merely a means to an end. The key to the tyranny of the sun is Serana herself. When I fled Castle Volcar, I fled with two Elder Scrolls. The scroll I presume you found with Serana speaks of Ariel and his arcane weapon, Ariel's bow. The second scroll declares that the blood of Coldhager's daughter will blind the eye of the dragon. Like myself, Serana was a human once. We were devout followers of Lord Molag Bal. Tradition dictates the females be offered to Molag Bal on his summoning day. You survive the ordeal. Those that do emerge as a pure-blooded vampire. We call such confluences the Daughters of Cold Harbor. It's what some call the domain of Molag Bal, his place in oblivion. Now you're beginning to see why I wanted to protect Serana, and why I've kept the other Elder Scroll as far from her as possible. If Harkon obtained Ariel's bow, and Serana's blood was used to take the weapon, the tyranny of the sun would be complete. In his eyes, she'd be dying for the good of all vampires. And how exactly do you plan on stopping him? Have you been listening to me? Like Serana, I'm a pure-blooded vampire. My presence on Tamriel is as much of a danger as hers. You care nothing for Serana, or our plight. Whether or not you've become one of us in order to survive the Soul Care, you're still a vampire hunter at heart. You're here because we're abominations in your mind. Evil creatures that need to be destroyed. I see. You're simply here to stop the tyranny of the sun, despite the cost to Serana. Nothing else matters. This stranger aligns himself with those that would hunt you down and slay you like an animal. Yet I should entrust you to him.
This stranger has done more for me in the brief time I've known than you've done in centuries.
How dare you! I gave up everything I cared about to protect you from that fanatic you call a father.
Yes, he's a fanatic. He's changed. But he's still my father. Why can't you understand how that makes me feel?
Serana, if you'd only open your eyes. The moment your father discovers your role in the prophecy, that he needs your blood, you'll be in terrible danger.
So, to protect me, you decided to shut me away from everything I cared about? You never asked me if hiding me in that tomb was the best course of action. You just expected me to follow you blindly. Both of you were obsessed with your own paths. Your motivations might have been different. But in the end, I'm still just a pawn to you two. I want us to be a family again, but I don't know if we can ever have that. Maybe we don't deserve that kind of happiness. Maybe it isn't for us. But we have to stop him before he goes too far. And to do that, we need the Elder Scroll.
I'm sorry, Serana. I didn't know. I didn't see. I've allowed my hatred of your father to estrange us for too long. Forgive me. If you want the Elder Scroll, it's yours. Your intentions are still somewhat unclear to me. But for Serana's sake, I'll assist you in any way that I can. Yes, I've kept it safely secured here ever since I was imprisoned. Fortunately, you're in a position to breach the barrier that surrounds these ruins. You need to locate the tallest of the rocky spires that surround these ruins. At their bases, the barrier's energy is being drawn from unfortunate souls that have been exiled. Destroy the keepers that are tending them, and it should bring the barrier down. One more word of warning. There's a dragon that calls itself Durnavir roaming the cairn. Be wary of him. The Ideal Masters have charged him with overseeing the Keepers, and will undoubtedly intervene if you're perceived as a threat. When I entered the Soul Cairn, I had intended to strike a bargain with the Ideal Masters, the custodians of this place. I requested refuge in the Soul Cairn, and in exchange, I would provide the Ideal Masters the souls that they craved. If I had foreseen the value they placed on my own soul, I would never have come here. The Ideal Masters unleashed their keepers and sent them to destroy me. Fortunately, I was able to hold them at bay and retreat into these ruins. Unfortunately, yes. Since the Keepers weren't able to claim my soul, they had their minions construct a barrier that I'd never be able to breach. Time has very little meaning to me. Consequently, it has little meaning to the Ideal Masters as well. I suppose you could call this the ultimate waiting game, each watching the other to see which will give in. Harkon's vision is a world plunged in eternal darkness, where the vampire can flourish, and never again fear the tyranny of the sun. What he fails to realize is how much attention would be called to our kind if the prophecy came to fruition. If eternal night fell, there are many who wouldn't stand for it. They would raise armies in attempts to return things to normal. The order of the day would be our destruction. Until every last vampire was hunted down and eliminated. I do. It's how the vampire has survived for millennia, and the only way we can continue to survive in the future. Be careful, and keep my daughter safe.
you know I visited elsewhere once? What a strange and wondrous place.
Thank you. on.
No, you don't.
Not very impressive.
I'm not someone to be trifled with.
end well for you.
Someone to be trifled with.
Who's there?
There they are.
Does anyone expect me to write my opus with all of these rude interruptions? What do I mean, indeed? If I hadn't lost all of the pages, I wouldn't be in this predicament, and we wouldn't be having this conversation. And you think I do?
I can feel it. He's such a loyal beast. Here, I'll teach you how to call him to you.
He'll help you get around. Goodbye, hero. Take care of Arvak for me.
Such a good horse.
Let's kill those keeper things and get back to the prison. Sure thing. Just you against the world now. Not that I'm complaining. As a fellow Nord, what do you think of me? Like it, hate it, good father. It seems like most of us can't go a single day without it, but I'd like to hear your thoughts. Glad we're on the same page then. I may have an extraordinarily high tolerance for alcohol, but that doesn't mean I don't like it. Or at least, trying. Haven't succeeded, I think, ever, but that's a little life goal. Thank you.
You managed to destroy all three keepers? Very impressive. Yes. Please, follow me. Keep watch for Durnafir. With the prison's barrier down, he's almost certain to investigate.
I'm glad you're here. I don't think I could be doing this alone. It still feels kind of weird, waking up after thousands of years, even at this point. Just thinking about an empire in Syria. I definitely thought everything would end with the rebels.
Forgive my astonishment. I never thought I'd witness the death of that dragon. Volumes written on Durnafir allege that he can't be slain by normal means. It appears they were mistaken. Unless the soul of a dragon is as resilient as its owner's scaly hide. It's possible that your killing blow has merely displaced Durnafir's physical form. Minutes. Now, let's get you the Elder Scroll, and you can do it.
last scroll. Come on, let's take it to Dex here.
Now that you've retrieved the Elder Scroll, you should be on your way. I have no choice. As I told you before, I'm a daughter of Cold Harbor. If I return to Tamriel, that increases Harkon's likelihood of bringing a tyranny. I appreciate your concern for me. But Serana, remember that Harkon is, and promise me you'll keep my daughter safe. She's the only thing of value I have left. Do you have anything to ask before you depart? Farewell. Remember that Harkon's not to be trusted.
Stay your weapons. I would speak with you, Quinarin. Cursed, not dead. Doomed to exist in this form for eternity. Trapped between Laas and Enoch. Between life and death. The hostility was necessary. I was bound to an oath. I believe in civility among seasoned warriors, and I find your ear worthy of my words. My claws have rendered the flesh of innumerable foes, but I have never once been felled on the field of battle. I therefore honor name you Quinarin, or Vanquisher in your tongue. Your words do me great honor. My desire to speak with you was born from the result of our battle, Quinarin. I merely wish to respectfully ask a favor of you. For countless years, I've roamed the Soul Cairn in unintended service to the Ideal Masters. Before this, I roamed the skies above Tamriel. I desire to return there. I fear that my time here has taken its toll upon me. I share a bond with this group. If I venture far, I will place my name with you and grant you the... Do me this simple honor, trivial in your mind, but I don't require an answer, Quinarin. Sim, there was a time when I called Tamriel my home, but those days have long since passed. The Dovah roamed the skies, vying for their small slices of territory that resulted in immense and ultimately fatal battles. I was, but unlike some of my brethren, I sought solutions outside the norm in order to maintain my superiority. I began to explore what the Dovah call the I. In return, I discovered too late. They had control of my mind. Free? No. I have been here too long, but the Soul. I only hope that you will allow me the precious moments of time there through your call.
Thank you.
What do you... Let's just... How in the name of Zenith are... I used to be one of the best. And what exact... The only... Bring me some odds and eggs. Tell me what you're looking for, and maybe we can make a deal. If you have the husks. Understand a word of it. Maybe it will do you some good. I might just be a soul now, but I'm still not going to give my stuff away. Bring me at least 20 masks, and then we'll talk.
The last time I argue with a Gamora.
Sorry.
You're back. I thought you were dead, or something happened, or I thought... What about Alduin? Is he gone? I feel so relieved. Oh, to be proven wrong has never felt better. Hey, so, well, I'm here if you need me. About what happened right before we entered the Soul Camp. I don't know how you're okay with all this. Was it really worth it, exchanging your mortality so that we could find my mother and get the scroll? But you're no longer human anymore. I took that away from you, and I don't know how I feel about that. It's my fault. I brought this up. If you didn't know, then I'm sorry. I got caught up in the past for a moment there. I wouldn't want something to ever get forced on you. I don't want to see a repeat of my life in yours. But I'm glad that you reminded me of this. You chose this. What about Isran and the others? You have become the very thing that you swore to destroy. I've heard that there's someone named Falian in Morthal. Maybe you should go speak with him.